MATLAB is a computing software offering computing advantages for all engineering disciplines. To learn more, go to the MathWorks website. Select the Academia tab. Here, you'll find tutorials that'll help you learn about the different features and develop skills. Select MATLAB examples to find the library of videos that may be valuable in future script development. These Getting Started videos walk through many different examples, but this video jumps right into MATLAB, showing how to write equations and plot graphs. Open MATLAB to view the typical home screen. The main window is called the command window. This is where you can enter basic commands. For example, compute x equals 2 plus 2 and y equals x squared. The answers display in the command window and in the workspace. The workspace shows all variables and their current values. Below the workspace is the command history window. It displays all commands used in the command window in chronological order. Since this problem will be long and difficult to keep track of easily in the command window, we will use a script. To open a script, click the New Script button. This will open the editor window. Here, you can enter all your commands before running them. First, type the command CLC followed by a semicolon. The CLC command clears the command window, and the semicolon will suppress the output so the command does not appear in the command window. Next, type the command clear, again followed by a semicolon. This will clear all stored variables and their values. Finally, enter format compact. This command is not necessary, but it eliminates extra line spacing, saving room in the command window. To run this code, press the green play button labeled Run. You will be prompted to save the file before MATLAB will execute the code. After clicking Save, choose Add to Path in the pop-up window to add your specified folder to the MATLAB path. As you can see, the command window has been cleared and all variables in the workspace have been erased. Now that our script is formatted, we can begin inputting our known variables. To enter a variable, simply type the name followed by an equal sign and its value. Although not necessary, it is useful to keep track of variables' units using comments. Comments are strings of text that do not output to the command window. To create a comment, type a percent symbol followed by the desired text. We would like to find the force and pressure at multiple gate heights. To do this, we will use the linspace command. Linspace creates a specified number of points spaced equally between two values. For this example, we will calculate values for gate heights from 0 to 6 feet. The hinge is assumed to always be level with the surface of the water. To do this, simply type the starting value of 0, the ending value of 6, and the number of points desired, 10, all separated by commas. To find the force on the block, we must first solve for the horizontal force on the gate. Next, we need to find the location of this force. Finally, we need to find the force of the block on the gate by summing moments about the hinge. Now, let's enter our equations. To type an equation, start with the variable being solved for, followed by an equal sign and the expression. In this case, the units of pressure will be in pounds per square foot. We would like to convert this to pounds per square inch. To do this, simply divide by 12 inches squared, or 144. Now, because the variable h is stored as a matrix, we must use a period before the operator. The period tells MATLAB to square each value in the matrix. It was not needed above because we were simply multiplying and dividing the matrix h by a scalar value. Press the Run button to evaluate the equations. The results of the equations are displayed in the command window as matrices. They are also stored in the workspace under the variables P and FB. To graph the results, use the plot command. Type plot followed by the variables we wish to plot inside a set of parentheses. We want pressure on the x-axis and height of the water on the y-axis, so type P, H. Once the code is executed, the graph appears. Now we would like to enhance the appearance of the graph by adding a title, axis labels, etc. To change line color and style, type the first letter of the color, followed by a symbol resembling the desired data marker. B-hyphen-hyphen will result in a blue dashed line. To add a title, type title, followed by the desired text in a set of apostrophes and parentheses. To continue a line of code on the next line, type three periods and push enter. Add labels to each axis by entering X label and Y label. Enter text using the same syntax used for the title. Use set to change axis options. First, enter the current axis handle, which is GCA by default. Minor tick marks are enabled on each axis by using X minor tick and Y minor tick. Both are off by default, so on needs to be entered after each. Because pressure increases as you go down in the fluid, not up, the y-axis needs to be inverted. This is done by entering y-dir, then reverse. After these changes, the graph reflects the results much better and looks more professional. Use the same commands for the next graph, changing titles and variables where necessary. Here, the line color and title are changed, as well as the variable we wish to plot and axis labels. After executing the code, the graph for the force on the gate appears. The pressure graph is now hidden because, unless prompted to do otherwise, MATLAB will plot both graphs in the same window. The most recent graph will appear. To display both graphs in the same window, we will use the subplot command. Subplot organizes the graphs into rows and columns. In this command, m is the number of rows, n is the number of columns, and p is the position of the graph. Position is numbered from left to right, top to bottom. We would like the graphs to be stacked horizontally, so we need two rows, one column, and the top graph to have a position of 1. Use the same number of rows and columns for the second graph, but this time with a position of 2. As an example, if the number of rows and columns were reversed, the graphs would appear side by side. Now both graphs appear in the same window, one above the other.